Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome to our 100,000 YouTube subscriber special montage reaction video, whatever you want to call it. Thank you all very much for the support here. I really do appreciate it. I figured, why not? You know, why not go back and take a trip down memory lane? Now, there was a couple of things I was planning on doing for the 100,000 subscriber video, and one of them happened. I was thinking about putting like a little, just like a little sign on Daisy on my Shih Tzu and letting her run around in the yard like she's all happy and stuff. But unfortunately, at the time of this recording, she's not feeling that great, and I don't want to stress her out. So instead, I'm going to go with another idea, which is we're going to go back in time and take a look at some of our old classic favorites from the channel. Hopefully, this video isn't too long. I also am recording this live from Twitch, so Twitch chat's going to keep me honest and make sure that I don't go overboard. And I'm just going to go through a lot of my old videos, kind of react to the more special moments, and just take a trip down memory lane, talk about like maybe some special things that happened. I'm also going to be taking requests from Twitch chat, so I'm going to try to keep this video as short as possible. Hopefully it's not over an hour, but I wouldn't be surprised because you all know that, well, you all know how I can get whenever we take a trip down memory lane. There's also, you may hear that there's no music in the background. That's because we are going to be listening to audio from all the videos, of course. So yeah, we're just going to get started. I'm going to show you, I do have a desktop capture set up for this. So, and you can find that right here. Oh boy, this is going to be either the best video or the worst video. I haven't decided which one. Also, thank you to Nefetz Was Taken once again for that meme of the day. I know that we had that one in Isaac video this week, but I wanted to just show it anyway. So, without further ado, here we go. This is the first published video that I can actually show. There's three other videos that precede this video, but unfortunately I can't show it due to privacy reasons, and also they've been taken down from YouTube and demonetized anyway. So, but this one comes from, I believe, from SS Radio, like number 3, maybe even number 2. It was released way back when, on November 30th of 2012. It is possible that this video is older than some of the people that watch my channel. And it was one of the first times that I ever tried an impersonation. Hopefully the volume balance isn't all that bad. But yeah, so this first clip here, you're going to actually hear the other half of SS Radio in terms of separate crowd. He's no longer, of course, doing anything with YouTube and stuff, but he's still a friend of mine. And yeah, you can hear my terrible axe impersonation. I thought it was good back in the day.
Axe
from Dota 2. He's a character.
Ah.
Named Axe. I love Axe just because his one-liners are great. Middle is missing according to Axe.
So bad.
Axe needs healing.
I think Broloff from League of Legends is more along my more my fancy.
Oh god, if you look at the scroller, we actually did have a hotline. And then back this up. We actually did have a hotline that you could call. And we had some people leave some voicemails and like ask questions. I mean, when I originally started, SS Radio was like, I thought that was going to be my big calling card.
Along my more my fancy. He says
SS
a lot of bro
Radio
stuff.
SS Radio number 31, according to Axe.
Oh, 31. There you go.
All right. That's how you have to do all the intros from now on. I hope you appreciate the work that I've given you.
He kind of got a little piratey there at the end there, but yeah, that's I'm no
kind of
maybe he is a pirate. I mean,
he
may
be piratey.
Axe may very well be so. And
piratey, I was like piety. I was like Path of Exile wasn't out back then, but piety. Yeah, that's John St. John, by the way, is a voice actor for Axe. So, and then we go on. I actually timestamped this one here. I believe that this is the first time that I ever actually lost it on the microphone, reacting to what was going on. This is like SS Radio. This is only like the second time I ever played it. And my brother Tempo, who you may know from StarCraft 2 from those days, he wrote the song When I'm Grandmaster. This one actually is one of the first times that I streamed Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, and I also lose it. I absolutely lose it on stream. What happens?
No, oh, Ilya was gored by a narwhal. No, Tempo. And poisonous jellyfish. Oh, God, it's just Tempo. Come on, Tempo. Oh, yeah, collect the jellyfish hide. There you go.
Remember, this
oh,
is,
nice.
This is the second time I ever played the game, I think.
Come on, Tempo. Come on. Oh, my God. This is insane.
Tempo was also watching during this.
No, Tempo. Ugh. Tempo landed on an island to catch his breath. Tempo made it somehow. Tempo noticed some supplies sitting on the beach. He left the wagon to investigate. Oh, shotguns and health. Nice. Tempo then realized why supplies were left there. The supplies were guarded by a flock of angry pel- What? Pelly- Oh, my God. This is not fun at all. Tempo was somehow killed by a pelican.
Yeah, the good old pelican scene. It killed me because Tempo was in the chat at the time.
Oh man.
Tempo was in the chat at the time, and like that was the first time we had ever seen that.
Oh man.
I wish I had captured the
somehow by a pelican.
I wish I had captured the chat from that. Oh, the good old classic Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Oh man. Oh man. Whoa, we're getting rated on Twitch. Thank you, Rob and Jess as well. Again, those of you watching this on YouTube, I am simultaneously recording this live on Twitch as well because I wanted to share the love here for the 100,000 subscriber reaction video. Now, this next video is one that you all probably have never seen before. It features some very awesome people from an old network that I was once briefly affiliated with called Rivalcast Network, and they had a promo. They had a promo announcement whenever the network was actually first launched, and we were tasked with making ourselves a just sort of like an introduction, like highlight reel, thing for the YouTube channel, which is no longer around anymore. But this one was you're going to hear a couple people who either no longer do online radio anymore or they just don't do anything. So this is the trailer and the live reaction to one of my friends Emperor, him and Varyar from back in the Rivalcast days. Needless to say, I think I got a little overzealous because, of course, this was back in my YouTube, or this was back in my Warcraft editing days. So I was still very knee deep in YouTube video editing, and needless to say, I may have gone a little overzealous with the with my trailer compared to everyone else's.
Three. I don't know what 73 is, but okay. Yeah, Grand Old Podcast. All right, so that's three.
Jim, okay,
we're getting there.
Solid.
All right, so
we've got an interview show, a music show, a variety show. You know, we really need at least one other solid show to complete a basic bare bones lineup.
I suppose it'd be nice, maybe a video show of some sort.
Oh, that would really round things out.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Sin Victa, and I am thrilled to announce to you that my show, SS Radio, is now a part of the Rivalcast Media Network. I will be bringing you all of my thoughts on gaming, music, sports, and anything else that I may be burning about two times a week, only on the Rivalcast Media Network. I am looking forward to interacting and chatting with you all, and there's only one thing left to say. SS Radio on the Rivalcast Media Network. Oh, hell yeah.
Man,
that was a great.
Man, that was, sorry, no.
That was great. It's
true.
Awesome.
Yeah. Even back then, I did kind of overdo it back in the day. That was the reaction to my completely like the other people who submitted stuff, like they were good, but they weren't like super over the top. Like this guy's name is Sakani.
Hello, Sakani here. It is with great fanfare that I would like to announce that my show, the BGM Video Game Music Podcast.
Yeah, so that's Sakani, and then another guy who I followed before I even met him on Rivalcast was Sayomara. Vesper.
Grand Old Podcast. I'm excited to announce you.
I should also probably mention that I'm the one who edited this video, So they had audio promos and stuff, and then I edited the video to match what they said for their promos. But this was done by me, like the transitions and stuff, but they made the videos and I just synced everything up. So that was Sakani Saomara.
I'm excited to announce here on Burst Court tonight that I will be joining Rival Cast Media with a bunch of the other fine shows.
And then this Joker.
Opportunity.
Introduce myself. My name is Sinvicta, and I am thrilled to announce to you that my show, SS Radio, is now a part of the Rival Cast Media Network. I will be bringing you all of my thoughts on gaming, music.
Yeah, sorry if the video got a little bit loud there, but yeah, That's Sinvicta for sure. And we also have another classic clip here coming from My Brother Tempo, except this time you can actually see him. So backstory on this is from May 2013. Backstory on this one. Yeah, I know that was some great logo masking. I know back then I was a Photoshop genius and editing genius. I'm way better at video editing than photo editing. So the backstory on this one, this was a promo video that I cut for our second SS Radio Open, which is a StarCraft II Open tournament for everyone gold and under. And the clip that you're about to see, I made out of a clip. I went back and recorded it from Tempo's VOD, and Tempo is a notorious arachnophobe. So what I did was I took a screen capture of Tempo's face. Let me show it to you right now. I took a screen capture of Tempo's face from this screen here, and I superimposed a spider behind him. But the reason why that was done was because of what you're about to see. There's an actual spider that crawls on Tempo's wall right in front of him, and then I ended up using that for a I end up using that for a promo. Here you go.
Oh my God, there's a spider on my wall!
Keep calm and join.
That was the first time I actually had to censor someone too, for YouTube's sake. Now he didn't know that. He didn't know that I was watching live when that happened. And then so what I did, you'll see the picture in a second.
Yeah, go man! I don't even know where it went. Oh man.
The spider disappeared. He never found him. But don't worry, I found him. Music's from Secret of Mana, by the way. But remember, he didn't know that I was watching during that time.
Alright, folks. I'm about to be out of here now. Oh, what the f***? Sinvicta, dude, what the f***? You're a d***. I hate you. I hate you. You're
a d***. Yeah, emotional support. So here's this is the still. Let me go back to the picture.
And now.
So that's the moment that Kwame saw it. So this is all I did. All I simply did was put that behind him. I just googled a random spider. I put it behind him and Tempo flipped out. Remember, he's a well-known arachnophobe.
I'm about to be out of here now. Oh, what the f***? Sinvicta, dude, what the f***? You're a d***. I hate you. I hate you. You're
a d***. Look at the old Twitch dashboard, by the way. Anyway,
click a stupid picture and see what, like, I'm looking at him like, why would he, this doesn't even look like he did anything to it. And then I realized it was a spider.
Oh, don't worry. We get him again.
Oh, man. Click this stupid picture. DisciplesofMayhem.com TS11.
Disciples of Mayhem was my clan. Was my clan that we made back in StarCraft 1.
I'm thinking it was a regular picture. And I'm like, why would he just take a picture of me? Like, it's weirdo.
So Tempo didn't know what time the tournament started, and later on during the stream he was asking.
Oh, you're so funny, man. I'm not looking at it again.
Here we go. Minutes later, Tempo attempts to remember what time the SS Radio Open number 2 starts. Invicta provides a chat with another useful link to help his brother out in his time of need. And I think you already know where that link is going.
Invicta is doing the SS Radio Open number 2 Golden Under Tournament. That's going to be at 12 p.m. Pacific. 3 p.m. Eastern. And I want to say 2100 CEST. Am I right? Is it 19? Is it 1900 CEST? Ah, you son of a... I hate you. Shut the f*** on.
I have to stop the video here because I end up playing some copyrighted music at the end. Oh, my brother. My brother. Don't worry. I always got your back. It was the exact same picture.
Oh, that's funny, man.
It was the exact same picture and the exact same link. I knew that he wouldn't look at the link again. So... this video here was by request. So this video comes from the good old days when I used to actually play the game called Scrolls. And this is from the Scrolls beta all the way back in 2013, June 18th, 2013. Yeah, it was the exact same link. This video will probably get demonetized because of the 8-bit video or the 8-bit music is actually good enough to get flagged, but whatever. This was my idea of photoshopping. I was so proud. I was like, okay, remember, this is back from 2013. I was like so proud. I was like, okay, I gotta match the color scheme, and I'm gonna be smart about this. I'm gonna take a screenshot of the logo, and then I'm gonna go in Photoshop and I'm gonna copy the brown stroke that's around the letters to make it look as professional as possible. What font do they use? Oh, I don't know what font they use. Well, I'm going to find one in the Windows library that looks similar. The Twitch mosh pit says it doesn't look bad. I think it looks terrible. And by the way, you can definitely tell how amateur I was back in those days. Like, the Scrolls logo is nowhere near centered on the screen. Like, the A almost touches the logo, but the S is nowhere near it. And how I did this back in those days, I did not know how to increase the font size of one character without increasing the size of the entire word. So this S and this A are both separate layers than the Invict on the middle, and I just tried to line them up as best I could. I didn't know about the alignment tool back then. But I think that this scroll, I actually did Photoshop this out of one of the in-game assets. I think that one came out pretty well. I don't even remember what I sound like back in those days.
Hey everybody, this is Sinvicta playing a little bit of Scrolls, and I just wanted to record this really, really quickly because this may be one of the most ridiculous things you have seen so far in this beta version of the game. Basically, let me set up the scenario for you. This was
actually recorded on the microphone that's on my head when I bought a brand new Sennheiser headset. That's where I had this. I think this was the Sennheiser, or it might have been the Blue Yeti, but you can already tell that I had a much better quality mic.
After 76 rounds, as you can see up here at the top in the round counter, I have been put in a position where I literally cannot place any unit on the board without it getting instantly killed by everything. Now, fortunately for me, the AI walled herself off to where she can't actually kill me. Basically what I've been doing for the past, 45 minutes or so.
Anyway, this is from the game Scrolls, and it was one of the games that I was really passionate about. It was also the first online trading card game I'd ever played. And I was a big fan. Like, if I remember correctly, the goal was to knock down three totems of your opponent. And there was a lot of positional based tactics. The units in front would act as the blocker. And unless you had a unit like that had trample or something like that, you had to hit the front blocker units before you could get to the more vulnerable ones in the back. And it was a really unique game. And I think that Skrulls would have done a lot better these day and ages, but this is back before Hearthstone was even a thing. And I was just a big fan of Skrulls, and I was making videos for it. So this one over here, this highlight is actually the first time. I don't have a particular time picked out, but this is the first time I ever attempted to cast StarCraft. This was shortly after I think the first SS Radio Open was announced. This is the first time I ever tried to cast it, like actual casting for a tournament on YouTube.
Pulled off all of his mining SCVs, so not a bad play from Tempo. He ends up saving it, kills four SCVs, and forces a pretty much cancellation of all mining for a good 20 seconds. So not that big of a deal there for Solrar, but again, Tempo did do a little bit of damage, taking four SCVs with him. And that second base is now up and running. We do have... someone's pinging. Oh, no, we actually have... I completely missed this. Two Widow Mines have actually made it into the mining...
I think I did okay back in the day. You can also notice the old... this is the old Observer UI as well for StarCraft 2. It just looks terrible, but I tried my best. I was a decent StarCraft 2 caster, I would say.
And a Raven, so a very, very grab-bag-ish type army for our Terran player, Solrar, who is still operating off of one base. His second orbital command is done, but unfortunately he's not deciding to take off.
It's so jarring to hear this now and listen to like the Monster Fight Night series.
Look at the Gateway Army real quick. We do have a proxy pylon set up for Tempo, warping in more Stalkers here. He's now up to 9 Stalkers, 3 Zealots, 1 Sentry, and a Mothership Core.
Now that I think about it, I think this isn't the old Observer UI. This is an old mod. Viking, this is like a modded map that we had to play.
Marines and Marauders.
Yeah, because you can see the Reddit logo up there.
Drone has been deployed for the Raven. And Tempo needs to back on out of there. He does know, he has to know that the Terran player is still stuck on one base. So if Tempo really wanted to, he could go add on a third, even fourth.
Just trying to do proper meta commenting, but not knowing much about the game. I was not Grandmaster back those days. I was only, I was only Diamond from way back then. This is from Wings of Liberty, like when the game, I think, fully released. I don't think this was in beta. But yeah, this was a long, long time ago. It's really crazy to see all these older videos pop up and stuff. Now, the next... whoops. Say, hey there, OBS. Hello. Hey, how you doing? The next video that you're going to see is the first time that I ever recorded GeoGuessr. So, the entire existence of me playing GeoGuessr can be traced back to this very video. It actually has over 2,000 views, which is insane. But this one... this one is from July 2nd of 2013. And I still use the 8-bit Metallica, and all of those videos ended up getting claimed, which I of course wasn't expecting at the time, but I wasn't that serious about YouTube.
Plays GeoGuessr. Oh, you weren't expecting that.
What was that? what was that? What sound did I just make? Hang on.
Without any further ado,
listen how bad the mic is clipping too.
Dun, 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 dun. Welcome to Sinvicta Plays GeoGuessr. Oh, you weren't expecting that, were you?
Oh man, what a fruitcake!
Yes, GeoGuessr. Oh, you weren't Sinvicta.
Hang on.
Oh, you weren't.
That needs to be the new sub alert, I think.
You weren't expecting that, were you? Yes. This is something that I have been streaming quite a bit for the past couple of days. And what you were
now let's see how did I do on my first ever round of GeoGuessr from way back
right
then.
Right now is GeoGuessing.
Let's see. I don't even think I can hit that note anymore.
What does the sign say? It's
look at the old GeoGuessr UI too.
Indoor storage. That's definitely English. Indoor storage, boats, RVs, and snow cars and snowmobiles. 218. What is that? what is that area code? Chat, do not look that up, please. Do not cheat for me.
What did I get in my very first round of GeoGuessr? I wish I could see the seed that I played.
Off. It was actually in Minnesota. So 218 is a Minnesotian.
Minnesotian.
Minnesotian area code. I have to say that I'm
10,248. Wow. Did I include the seed here? I did include the seed. I wonder if it actually still works. I'm scared. I'm kind of scared to click this, but I'm going to. Nope, it doesn't work. Rats. Well, I tried. So what I used to do back in these days was I used to have people post their score down below, and then I would the following video I would show, because again, this was, in all seriousness, this was my first foray into, I wanted to be interactive with my audience. So I would post the top three scores from the previous episode, and then I would take the top three from the comments section and then post their names and stuff and that sort of thing. And it made it pretty popular for the time. But inevitably, of course, people started cheating, and then it was like they would watch the video first, and then I had to you know, disqualify people for cheating, and then people were like, "Oh, how could you do that? That's my score. That was my actual score." Blah blah. And then I just dropped the whole idea. As with anything, the internet happened to ruin that one. But yeah, I mean, that's just where, you know, I just wanted to have some sort of interaction with my audience for GeoGuessr. So all the way back in 2013, that's nuts. And then this one was submitted by Gray Talon, of course. Quite possibly the most influential video on my channel to date. And this is the video that a lot of people originally came to my channel for, which of course is the Rarest Combo Ever video. That one was released on April 19th of 2018, which serves as the biggest turning point for my entire channel, obviously. And what's funny about this video, I've talked about it in the Isaac series before, but what's funny about this video in particular is that I wasn't planning on doing anything of anything important with this video at all. I was like, there's nothing special about this. And then I ended up getting the Godhead Sacred Heart combo, which I believe that we D100 did. Let's see if we can... It's towards like the middle or late stages of the game. Yeah, there's Godhead and Sacred Heart. It was this moment. See if we can find the exact time that I used the D100 here.
All right, we've got Godhead and Sacred Heart. What?
So... It didn't.
The shield is stuck there. All right. Yeah. So we got two of the rarest items in the entire franchise at the same time, and we just raised our tiers rate.
It didn't.
I think this is what we're gonna.
It didn't register with me at the time with just how ridiculous that combo was until I started looking up after the video had been recorded. Originally, I didn't have anything planned for the thumbnail. I didn't have anything planned for the title. I just was like, it was called just like, wow, or something like that. But I don't remember why I told myself that I should probably make a big deal out of this. And looking back on it, like, I had no good reason to do that, but I was still doing the old boring, like, oh, here's an Isaac thumbnail, and then, like, a title that doesn't really mean anything idea, because I didn't want it to come off as clickbaity for any of these things. But for some reason, I decided to, and, you know, and here we are... a year and a half later, and this video is still the biggest video that I've ever had on my channel in more ways than one. Twitch chat saying right now is saying, and that D100 role continues to pay the bills. That is true. That is absolutely true. But this is the video that a lot of people originally found me on, and you know, it really is incredible how it all started with just a mundane, kind of boring run. I mean, we were 23 minutes at depths 2. That's how bad that run was going. And who would have known that was going to be the turning point of That was going to be the turning point of my channel, of my entire life, actually. That one D100 role changed my entire life. As crazy and as silly as that may sound, it's unbelievable. So this one, I have another video that was requested. This isn't an older video, but I'm going to show this one because it was heavily requested in Twitch chat. Again, this one's from September 2018. I'm going to scroll through some more old videos in a second, but people wanted to see one of the most memorable moments from the first season of Lobotomy Corporation was in season one, when Coach Krendor gave his inspirational speech before we finally took down Tifereth in episode 57. And also keep everybody together. Everyone stays together. We roll as a unit. We can do this, team. This is the one we've been waiting for. We know how to handle this one. Everybody on Coach Krendor. Everyone take a knee.
It's so ridiculous. It's so ridiculous how football terminology and ideology has somehow pervaded its way into like every game that I play now. It happens to be right around Coach Krendor. Speed this up a little bit.
This is it. Twitch chat's pumped. Everyone's hyped. Gather around, everyone. Gather around. Take a knee. We need everyone in here. Rob, Husky, Mathis, everybody. Take a knee. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to work as a unit. We know how to handle this. We're in the lead right now. All right, we've got a one-score lead on them. They're going to hit us with everything they got. We got to keep an eye on Monk, keep an eye on Red Hood. Move as one, stick together. Watch your teammates' backs. You're as strong as the next player next to you. You work as one. We are Phalanx. This is our house. They're the visiting team. We're defending the home turf. They're going to hit us with everything they've got. And we're going to hit them with everything we've got. Make the big time plays. Smart decisions. Don't panic. Protect the person next to you. And let's get it done. Big time players make big time plays. Watch the ground. Don't worry about the pawns. Watch the tree. Watch out for Monk.
Friday!
Keep your eyes open. Your head on a swivel.
Sorry about that. That's the next video.
Cry, do it up.
Yeah. Good old classic.
Protect each other at all times. Keep your pads on. Keep your jerseys tucked in. And hit them with everything we've got. This is our turf. Here we go.
Oh, man. Back to old videos here for a moment. So this video that you're about to see, good old coach. I've been calling Coach Krendor coach for years now. It's funny. It's always funny to me that people actually also start calling him coach now. Thank you, UDev. And thank you to S-Reach for gifting the subs here. I've disabled the Twitch alerts for YouTube's sake. But going over here, now there's been many funny moments over the course of streaming as well as on YouTube, but none of them have made me collapse from just sheer laughter than this moment right here. This is one that I haven't played on YouTube before. But what happened with this clip is this comes from an old mod that was bugged. This is back from I forget the name of the mod that we had, but it's Husky's own custom StarCraft II mod, and Zettle, which is the name of the actual programmer who made it. This one was made by Zettle, and one of the bugs that was still in the game that ended up becoming a feature of the map is the fact that every ranged attacking unit in the game shot Banelings for some reason, and we're not sure how that happened. But then, of course, I rolled with it. I had a very long-running series called Friday Night Fan Fights, where I would cast. I would just simply live stream on Twitch. Back then, it was still. I don't know if it was still Twitch back then. I think it was. Yeah. You can see it on the bottom right. Great font, by the way. Great overlay. My photoshopping was so bad. But I used to do live commentary because at this point I was hip deep in casting and stuff, and I loved doing esports. And this clip here is my real life best friend other than Husky, Justin. He is the Protoss player going up against the Terran player. Now, Justin's computer back in those days was not very good, and I convinced him to play on the show because we needed another player. So I'm responsible for getting him into this position. I didn't tell him about the mod that shot Banelings, and what you're about to see and hear, mostly hear, is the hardest I've ever laughed on the microphone ever, I think. And it's because I imagine my real life best friend looking over at me with like a very like disturbed, maddening smile, and then typing what he typed. And get ready for this.
The battle cruisers, I believe the battle cruisers are actually shooting.
Now at this point, you see here Kay Hammett, which is Justin. It says is slowing down the game. So I know his computer is struggling, but I didn't realize how bad it was struggling. So I'm gonna back it up a second and just let everything speak for itself.
Going to be tough to see. Look at that. The battle cruisers, I believe the battle cruisers are actually shooting the inners. Oh, a Hugger Lord coming in from the side, almost killing most of the battle cruisers for Morgan Fremen. I actually think that the battle cruisers were A moved onto the interceptors and they were killing themselves.
Oh, we've just started laughing. Don't worry, it gets worse.
I can't see. Okay, we got customers jumping on the car. Here come the battle cruisers. The horse is getting struck. Where are the battle cruisers? The carriers did nothing. The carriers did nothing. Missile turrets firing Banelings.
At this point, Twitch chat was actually worried that I had passed out. I'm still laughing, by the way. The downtime of audio that you're not hearing, that's still me laughing with the microphone on. I'm just laughing so hard that I'm not breathing.
Back saying this calls GG. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh.
Oh. There I go again.
Okay. All right. Backstage just can't figure out. He can't figure out a GG. Just type GG. Oh my god. There he goes.
It's like going into minute five now.
I'm okay. I am okay. Thank you for watching this. Thank you for watching Friday Fan Fights number 15. Oh, God. We'll see you. See you later tonight for Heroes of the Storm streaming. You can find the VODs on youtube.com/Invicta316. If I live that long. Thank you. Congratulations to Mark.
Yeah, so that is the longest, that is the longest sustained laughter that I've ever had on the microphone, period, in all of my career. another one of this is the only known footage that I know of anyway of me actually cracking up on camera. This would make NG Wolf Gamer real nostalgic. This is back when GTA 5 first came out for the PC, and this was one of the first heists that we attempted to do. And it gets a little wacky. This was like the fourth or fifth attempt that we were trying to do so, and we were failing miserably for this. And the results speak for itself. That's all I'll say. This is the only time that I know of that I've been seen cracking up on camera.
Move it! How's this truck going faster than that truck?
Here it comes.
How's that truck so much slower than this one? Good idea. That was a great job. Way to go, Spirit of Fire. Dumbasses.
And then I see a tractor just drive by.
Oh, man.
Can't believe this is 4 years ago.
Oh, God.
So the backstory on this is I was actually at... I was actually genuinely annoyed at Spirit of Fire for running into me. I didn't know he was that close behind me. I had to slow down because I don't remember who. I think it was Medrise who was driving the truck in front of us. I had to slow down, and then Spirit of Fire hit my truck with his truck, and it was legitimate actual annoyance. But once I saw Medrise's body flip out, do like a starfish eagle, like spread eagle cartwheel, and I saw the Spirit of Fire's truck go over the ledge, that's when I lost it.
How's that truck so much slower than this one? Good idea. That was a great job. Way to go, Spirit of Fire.
It was seeing Spirit of Fire's truck go off the edge which sent it off. And one final thing I'll say, right? You'll see, right? There. Right there. Right there, I got a massive cramp on my right oblique, because I don't laugh that hard that often, but I actually get two massive cramps that were extremely painful, But I was laughing so hard I couldn't stop the hurt, and I was in a lot of pain while laughing. It hits me twice. That was one of them. I'm still hurting right here. And then it happens again in a second, I think. Yeah, you can tell from my expression I'm still in pain. Like this is not the face of someone who's happy. I'm in immense pain right now. And then thankfully the cramp went away, because it hurt like hell, man. That really hurt. That really hurt. Now, another classic clip. Is from the game called Block and Load. And this was one of the first ever sponsored things that I ever did, and it was thanks to Jesse. It was thanks to Jesse for getting me into this. And what you're going to see is essentially Crendor doing Crendor things in a game that was very, very wacky and goofy. I need to find the actual video of it here on YouTube, but this is probably the second hardest that I've ever laughed on YouTube ever. Let me go to Chrome is being kind of a butt right now, and of course we've already gone over half an hour just because we pretty much thought we would. If I can find it, I may not be able to actually find it. Yeah, I can't. I don't know where that one is. I don't know where that one is. I wish I had this one pulled. Yeah, here it is. Here it is. This video was taken from Jesse Cox, from his point of view. This was used with Jesse's permission, and what Crendor does, Crendor decides that he's going to build this bridge, right? Or no, Crendor, I'm the one building the bridge. Crendor decided that he's going to make a launch pad and launch over to the enemy's base. So the very quick TLDR in this game is that it's PvP. And it's kind of like Minecraft PvP. The objective is to kill the other enemy's core. And they had these jump pads. And Crendor decided to get the bright idea to make a super jump pad that led straight to the enemy's base. And the results are quite possibly one of the hardest laughs that I've done ever.
There we go.
Oh, there we go.
Remember, you're watching Jesse's point of view.
Don't get stupid.
I wonder if they're ever going to look up. Hopefully they won't.
Yeah, hopefully not.
I'm making the bridge.
Oh, they definitely... Look, they built down... They built a thing around their base.
Dude, you want to see? Watch me. Watch my speed jump.
Don't do it. You're going to die. You're going to die. You're just going to die.
Wait,
stop it.
Go, Crendor. Go.
You're a ninja! Oh my god! You just fucking... You just flew into your death! Oh my god! I just got shot in the face laughing! Oh my god, I just got shot in the face laughing at that.
It was worth it though.
Alright.
That was not at all worth it. Oh my god, you big dummy. Oh, Crendor, you dumb dummy.
The funniest part for me was the fact that Crendor said samurai when he's supposed to be a ninja. He's a freaking ninja. It was just so good. So that one, I can't show that one, but it's one of the many times that that we had a fun Crendor video. And so going back to scrolls really quickly, we'll wrap the video up because it's like almost an hour, because of course it is. This is the first legitimate effort at doing like professional editing for YouTube and for like a guide itself. Oh my god. I forgot it was so bassy. Yeah, I can't show that one. Sorry, let me zero.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sinvicta, and welcome to my beginner's guide for the game Scrolls. In this series, I will be focusing on teaching you how to get started, as well as the basics and preparation and strategy that is involved with playing Scrolls. In part one of our series, I will be providing you an introduction to getting started, the three factions that are currently in the game, and how to begin your first match.
I don't remember how to play at all.
Let's get started by taking a look at the main menu when you log into Scrolls for the very first time. So here we are at the main menu after you log into the game.
So I was really hoping that Mojang was going to use this video, which is the reason why I put a lot of effort into it, and they didn't.
I will briefly describe each of the categories located at the top of the screen. The arena is where you will be spending the majority of your time while playing Scrolls.
It was also the first time that I'd ever written a script for myself, because I do have a stammering problem every now and then if I'm speaking too quickly and my brain can't catch up.
This is where you will battle with other players.
That's the reason why I sound so robotic.
Abilities against the AI's trials, which gradually increase in difficulty, and where you can also queue for a random quick match versus the computer. The deck builder is where you will craft your collection of scrolls and turn them from a pile of meaningless scraps of paper into a force to be reckoned with. The store is where
I was trying so hard to make it professional. You gotta give me at least props for trying here. And one other video I will show everyone before we wrap it up here. Just taking a trip down memory lane. As much as you have seen on my channel Overwatch, you probably have not seen all that much of it, to be honest, but one series in particular was also a pretty big turning point for me, and it was my first ever invite by Blizzard, from Blizzard, to do something official for them. So a long time ago, they asked me if I would play in the Overwatch alpha. Of course I did, and then they asked me, Zovia was she was StarCraft, but then moved to the Overwatch team. This was before it was made official. She actually asked me if I'd be interested in making an overview series on Overwatch and doing the sort of like character introductions and whatnot. And of course I said sure. I also asked her if I could have permission to cast some matches. So at the time I didn't know anything about the game at all. And Blizzard gave me access to a server where they had all of the closed alpha stuff from Overwatch. And I was lucky enough to actually get permission from Blizzard to post this on YouTube, because I wanted to be, essentially, I wanted to be an Overwatch caster.
Together we are strong.
It's crazy how involved I was with Overwatch.
Hello everybody, my name is Invicta, welcome to Overwatch. Today I'm going to be casting a match on the Temple of Anubis, which is a capture point map from the perspective of Zarya on the defending team. Joining her on defense are going to be McCree, Tracer, Zenyatta, Pharah, and Widowmaker going against the red team, which is comprised of Reaper, Zarya, Torbjorn, Pharah, Mercy, and Hanzo.
Now this was a pre-recorded match. This was not a live match, and these are all Blizzard devs going against each other.
For those of you who do not know how capture point maps work, basically this is how it goes. One team on offense, one team on defense. The defense has to stop the offense, and that is about it. I'm very excited to be bringing you Overwatch content here on the channel. And man, can I not wait for this game to come out here, as Tracer is already going to have to use Recall there to get away from Reaper. Reaper now coming in with the Wraith form, doing a little bit of damage, but there you do see the protective barrier used by Zarya, and she's going to be able to take down Reaper. Nice job by the defense there, stopping Reaper, who was on the attack, going right after our Zarya player. Check out the long-range siege action coming in here from the particle cannon of Zarya, throwing out even the projective barrier on top of Tracer.
This was hell at the time, because I didn't know the name. I didn't know the actual names of the abilities, and Blizzard wanted, they wanted the names of all abilities to be correct and to be used in their correct context. So learning all those for every single character was very time consuming.
Keeping her alive, and look at that, she is able to get another kill on Pharah. Pharah goes down again, as Zarya has taken up a couple quick easy kills here on the Temple of Anubis. Very nice job indeed. You do see the meter down below in the middle part of your screen. Once that meter reaches 100%, Zarya will be able to use her ultimate ability, which is the Graviton Surge. Here comes more damage coming in from the Particle Cannon going after Hanzo. The Graviton Surge is ready, and Zarya can use that at any time, getting a little bit more of extra damage here on top of Torbjorn's turret. Down goes the turret. But Torbjorn is still alive. Zenyatta now attaching a Harmony Orb to Zarya to give her a little bit of HP regeneration. And there's the Graviton Surge. It's going to be old enough to take out Mercy. Mercy goes down. The enemy team Zarya also goes down as well. Five-player kill streak for our Zarya player going after Pharah. And will Pharah get taken out? I think she was actually.
This is my first foray into Overwatch content. The second biggest Overwatch content that I did on the channel was, again, this one was also asked by Blizzard for consideration. I don't think they considered me as an official video maker at the time, but I was in talks with doing the introduction videos for every character. And actually the reason why this video, this Lucio video, got so many views is because this was the first footage of Lucio that I was under embargo at the time. But I had gained access to Lucio before the world even knew about it. It was only certain influencers, casters, and then of course everyone with Blizzard. So this was my first big video that I did by myself, which was also in conjunction with Blizzard for these introduction, these hero introductions. They only asked me to do Lucio, but then I took it upon myself to do every single hero in Overwatch, which was very, very time consuming as well. I also was channeling Kevin, also known as Cloaken, from the Heroes of the Storm team that you'll probably hear a lot of influence from.
Hailing from Rio de Janeiro, the famous international DJ and freedom fighter himself, Lucio, the newest hero to arrive in Overwatch. Lucio was...
As a quick note here, I actually was the one who wrote the script. Blizzard didn't give me a script, but what I did get instructed to do was, again, to talk about the actual names, to not use descriptions other than the actual names of every ability.
The newest hero.
But I wrote the script. Blizzard didn't.
Arrive in Overwatch. Lucio is a highly mobile support hero, capable of buffing and healing his allies while on the move.
Come on, let's bring it together.
Lucio wields the Sonic Amplifier, a weapon that is capable at firing sonic projectiles at Lucio's target. Lucio's right-click ability is Sound Wave. Sound Wave creates a blast of sound that will knock back nearby enemies. Lucio's shift ability is Crossfade.
Yeah, time to heal up.
Crossfade is Lucio's active support ability that provides benefits to allies through his music. He can switch between two songs at any time. One song increases the movement speed of his allies, while the second song provides rapid health regeneration to keep them going in the fight. Lucio's E ability is Amp It Up.
Amp It Up!
When Amp It Up is activated, the effectiveness and power of his crossfade abilities increase throughout its duration, allowing Lucio to bolster his teammates to an even greater degree than before.
Now remember, this was being seen by the bigwigs at Blizzard on the Overwatch team at the time, which is the reason why it's presented in such a way.
Drop the beat.
Lucio's ultimate ability is Sound Barrier. Sound Barrier creates a temporary but powerful shield around allies that grants them a large pool of temporary health, which will decay over time. Finally, there's Lucio's passive, Wall Ride. Wall Ride allows Lucio to skate along walls and remain safe by reaching areas of the map that are hard to reach for his opponents. Wall Ride gives Lucio incredible mobility while Soundwave provides him with powerful crowd control. Crossfade makes him a reliable frontline support while Sound Barrier rounds out Lucio's amazing effectiveness at improving the strength of his team. Lucio's leadership makes him a superstar on the battlefield, and his music became a cornerstone for positive change in his country. If you want to write the soundtrack for a better tomorrow and be the foundation that supports any team, join the ranks of Overwatch as Lucio.
Yeah, I was really proud of those videos. They took, they did take a lot of time to do back in the day. And I think what I will do to end this one here, because there's one more game that definitely requires a little bit of love, is one that I owe, other than Isaac, but one thing that I definitely owe Northern Lion, I owe NL a lot for. But the game, of course, Darkest Dungeon. I would have never heard of Darkest Dungeon if it wasn't for Northern Lion and seeing his first impressions. Now, this is actually before I even spoke to Northern Lion. I even knew who he was. I knew who he was, but of course, I was just a fan. I wasn't a friend at the time. And learning about Darkest Dungeon through him and playing through it was all of that is because of him. And one of my proudest moments after beating Darkest Dungeon for the season one was actually getting the privilege to interview a very important individual in the Darkest Dungeon world. In fact, he's the only voice that you hear actually speak anything in the game. And of course, that is Mr. Wayne June. And one of my favorite videos ever, even though it doesn't have a lot of views, but one of my favorite videos that I ever created was this one right here. This was the promo for Wayne's celebratory interview that I did after beating Darkest Dungeon for the very first time. And I got permission from Red Hook and from Wayne to create this video. Fun fact also, I even wrote this script, and it was really crazy and surreal to hear my script that I wrote come through like Wayne June's voice. It's crazy.
You have answered the letter and are a part of this place. Now, it is your turn to ask the questions. Join me as I sit down and answer them with Sin Victor this Saturday, July 30th at 5 p.m. Central, 6 p.m. Eastern at twitch.tv/SinVictor on SS Radio. This is Wayne June. I beg of you, join us as we speak of the Darkest Dungeon.
So all of that was, the audio editing was mostly Wayne, but the music and stuff in the background was created by me, and Wayne was I didn't even ask him to do any voice effects or whatever. He actually used the exact same ancestor voice effect that they used from Darkest Dungeon, the game itself. But anyway, I'm gonna wrap it up because of course I failed actually not going over an hour, 30 minutes, my butt. I hope you all enjoyed this journey back in time. Of course, there's also many, many other important moments in my YouTube career, but I just wanted to highlight some of the older ones and just do a little bit of a reaction video to show my support. And thank you to the Mosh Pit for supporting me all these years. If whether you are here from subs number 1 and 2 to subs 100,000 1 and 2, thank you all very much. I truly do appreciate it. And I want to thank you for allowing me to continue to entertain you for so many years and growing up with the channel. It's been an amazing journey, and it's not over. Nothing's over. We're going to keep on going. And my final words, thank you to Husky for pushing me to do this. Thank you to Total Biscuit, of course, for his longtime guidance. To Northern Lion, who I owe a lot to, for doing those first collabs with me in the culling. He definitely didn't have to do that, especially for some unknown Yahoo on YouTube who just wanted to play the same games as him. And there's so many other people that I owe a lot to here on YouTube, but those are the ones that I definitely think of first. And most importantly, the most important part, thank you all here on Twitch as well as on YouTube for supporting all of my content. And I promise you that I'll keep on going as long as you keep on watching. So until next time, keep it metal and be cool to each other. That's all I've got, everyone. Thank you very much. 100,000 plus thank yous to you all, guys and gals, here in the Mosh Pit. And I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.